Yo, what up, what up? It is CPA Strength back again, counting for beginners number 22. Strongest CPA in Florida. Now I already know when the neighbors in this building are like, who the fuck is this kid? And who the fuck gave him a CPA license? Jesus Christ, they need to tighten up these regulations. But guess what, I passed the test. So anyways, we're gonna do number 22 is trial balance. We're gonna do an unadjusted trial balance today. There is, let me get the fucking book. The definition in the book, and I'll put it in like I do's. Errors may occur in posting debits and credits from the journal to the ledger. The journal to the ledger. So the journal meaning the journal entries that you do, and then you transfer them into the ledger where you have separate T accounts. So journal entries to T accounts. When you transfer those, you might have errors. And one way to detect such errors is by preparing a trial balance. So that's what we're doing. We're trying to detect the errors. And that's why we're doing a trial balance. Because before, in earlier videos, we took journal entries from the general journal. In number 21, accounting for beginners number 21, we took the journal entries and it was a T account example. So if you haven't watched 21 and you were wondering where these accounts came from, their T accounts, watch 21 if you haven't seen it yet. This is the unadjusted trial balance. And that kind of means something because there is also, and I'll eventually get to them, there's other trial balances. There's an adjusted trial balance and a post-closing trial balance. All right, enough of the book. It's me and you, and let's do this. What do I think about a trial balance? I don't use trial balance in my day-to-day. I do my accounting, my bookkeeping through QuickBooks. You can't close out of the page unless your journal entries, debits, and credits match. That is basically the reason why you do a trial balance, is to make, like the book said, to make sure you don't have errors. But I want to go back to this was making me think of a story when I was taking a tax class, and part of the tax class was we do tax returns for the VITA program, the Volunteer Income Tax Assistance Program. So it's like an arm of the IRS, and we do tax returns for free for people who made less than $50,000 a year. It was really cool and I really learned a lot. I did a Saturday of tax returns, and then my teacher the next week said, oh, you don't really know how to do a tax return unless you do it by hand. And I'm like, yo, this guy's a fucking idiot. I just did a tax return last week. And I just did tax returns and it wasn't by hand. So this guy doesn't know what he's talking about. Fast forward another about 6-7 months, I'm taking an H&R Block learning class. And to be a tax preparer at H&R Block. So I'm taking the class and we didn't even touch a computer for, I think the class was 12 weeks long. We didn't even touch a computer for 6 weeks. So we did everything by hand. My teacher was right. I had no idea what the fuck was going on. You just punch a number in and here the number comes out and you don't really know the mechanics behind it. And you need to know the mechanics behind it. So I take that analogy kind of towards this, is where if you just start out in the computer system, you don't really know all the behind the scenes. So every step is important to do it by hand until you are very proficient at it. And then you can start using the computer and computer software. In the software, there's a lot of steps behind that you don't know what's going on. That's kind of why I think that everything is important. You don't want to skip steps. That's kind of why I got this book, so I can follow along with probably this book. It's probably similar to a lot of classes. And I don't want to skip steps because that, you think you're going to be ahead. Because for a certain moment you are ahead because you skipped all these steps and now you're working on this. But in the long run, it's going to bite you in the ass. Trial balance is, these are our T accounts that we had from number 20, AFB 21, accounting for beginners 21. So we'll go over these real quick. Cash, debit balance of $5,200. Okay, you're like, I don't know what a debit or a credit is. Okay, watch some older videos, and this is kind of my thing, the DCA, LUR, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. Watch my series, it'll help you learn. And as you can see here, as you're gonna see in this example, You don't really use, you've already figured out what's an asset or draw or an expense or anything. You're going to use debit and credit. Debit's always on the left, credit's always on the right. Here's what we had from when we made our TCATs before. Cash, debit balance 5,200. Loan, credit balance 10,000. Truck, debit balance 5,000. Rent, debit balance 500. Service income, credit balance 800. Draw, debit balance 100. To make sure that from the journal entries, these came up with the right balances, all the adding and subtracting, you're gonna have, this is just a very small example, and cash is the only one with multiple entries. In a ongoing business or in your class, you know, you might have 30 in here, 20 different accounts, so you've got a lot of adding and subtracting. So the trial balance makes sure that everything equals and is one of the reasons why I really like accounting, because it's very, nothing's really that hard once you know the steps. You just have to be very methodical, step by step and methodical. The unadjusted trial balance isn't, there's really not too much to it. You take your debit or credit balances from certain accounts here, and you have a line up and down, and then you transfer the debit or credit balances over here. See, debit on the left, credit on the right. Always, always, always. We got our cash, debit account 5,200. We have our cash over here in the trial balance, debit 5,200. Boom, taken care of. Now we have our loan account, and our loan T account, credit 10,000. Now in our trial balance, we have our loan account, credit for 10,000. Now for our third account, we have truck, debit for 5,000. Trial balance, truck, debit 5,000. Over here in our T account, rent, debit for 500. Now in our trial balance, we have our rent, debit 500. Our fifth T account, service income, credit of 800. Our trial balance, service income, credit 800. Debit on the left, credit's on the right. For our sixth account, we have draw with a debit balance of 100. In our T account, then we go to our trial balance. Draw, debit of 100. Really all we've done so far is we've taken our debits and credits from our journal entries. We've transferred the journal entries into the T accounts, and now we're transferring the T accounts to the trial balance. You're basically just transferring. You had to do all your thinking of, you know, is it a debit, is it a credit, is it an asset, is it a liability, what account is it? That all goes into the journal entry. So if you mess up there, you're really not gonna catch it here. Let's see if we've added and subtracted and transferred correctly. As you know, every journal entry equals. So it starts out equaling. So let's see if we've transferred correctly. Let's see if we've taken from journal entry to T account over to the trial balance. And how you do that is you add up all the debits of your different accounts and you add up all the credits. So let's do our debit. 5,200 plus 5,000, 10,200 plus 500, 10,700 plus 100, 10,800. Let's put some pluses here so everybody knows. And then over, so 10,800 is the sum of the debits. Now let's go to the credit. 10,000 plus 800, 10,800. So they equal. So we've done everything correct and we don't have any mistakes. And that right there is an unadjusted trial balance. Hope you liked it. I really love doing these videos. You guys' comments are great. Keep giving me some ideas for newer videos, please. Stuff that I haven't touched on. Or if there's something you're wondering about, you know, I can just reply to your comment and say, oh, I did a video. It's accounting for beginners number this. I'm no doctor, but I heard after a loss like this, the depression could be permanent. Feeling down? I got a chopper that could lift you up like some words of encouragement.